Hey there. So this is the Breville Barista Express, and I'm going to teach you how to adjust the grinder setting to give you good grinds. And this may help you if you're struggling with very quick coffee or very low pressure, even at the finest setting. So this method will work on the Breville Barista Express BS 870, which is this one, but it will also work on the earlier 870s, the 860, the Barista Pro 878, the Barista Touch 880, and the Oracles, and even the Smart Grinder Pro. So these machines from Breville come with two grind size settings. So there's the side adjustment on the dial here. You push forward to go finer. You bring it close to you to go coarse. Very simple. There's also an internal adjustment, and I'm going to teach you how to adjust that to give you a proper espresso. I just want to discourage you from applying other people's settings to your machine. If someone on the internet tells you to put the grind size at number 3 and change the internal setting to number 1, I wouldn't recommend you do that, because each machine is different. Even if I make the same coffee with the same settings on two machines, it won't be the exact same pressure and consistency. So each machine is different. You have to do this and you have to do it carefully. You want to do it carefully, because if you overdo it and you adjust the grind size too fine, the blades might actually damage each other and the grinder is pretty much grinding itself. So the way you adjust the internal setting is as follows. You want to take off the bean hopper. You want to get your vacuum hose, vacuum mutts on top. Then you want to adjust this to the coarsest setting. Then you undo this hopper, undo the top blade, the top burr. It can be really hard if you have coffee beans in there, so that's why I recommend you put it on coarse to give it some space. And you want to rotate it counterclockwise really tight. It'll be really tight sometimes, so you just have to give it that force. Then you want to take it out, vacuum this. There'll be coffee grounds on this as well. And then grab your vacuum hose. Vacuum it again here. Make sure you leave no coffee beans or coffee grounds in there, like I've left in here. I've already vacuumed it just now, so it should be fine. Okay. So, the way I like to adjust these machines is based on feel. So these, you can adjust the grinder settings either by making coffees, so changing the setting, making a coffee, and seeing if that's proper pressure. Or if you want to save some time and some beans, do what I'm doing here and just feel for the grinder, the blades touching or not touching. Obviously, that's a little bit subjective, you know, what I feel is different to what you feel, but hopefully I can give you a good enough description of how to do this. So you want to look at the grind size here on this blade. There's numbers 1 through 10, 1 being the finest, and almost always these machines come at number 6 from factory. That's about halfway, you know, close to halfway. Sometimes you don't have to adjust anything else. Sometimes the coffee comes out really beautifully with this setting, but also other times you have to adjust it to make it a little bit finer to give you that correct espresso pressure, which is around the 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock mark on this gauge. Okay, the way I like to adjust it is put this on the finest setting, all the way to the finest setting. And then you want to feel the resistance. You want to turn it clockwise and feel the resistance. When the blades are touching, you will feel a let me turn on the flashlight. When they're touching, you'll feel a resistance close to the end of this turning. So the way you put the burr this way, and you turn all the way to the right, and then there's a click. Just before the click, that's what you want to pay attention to. They should, if they're touching, this should be a little bit tighter toward the end. So almost like the blades are squeezing each other, squeezing in. I'm not feeling that here. So it's very loose. Ignore the sound. You might hear a metallic sound. That doesn't mean they're actually close to each other. So I'll put it all the way to 10. You still hear that metallic noise. That doesn't necessarily mean they're touching. You just want to feel for it. You want to feel them touching. And I'm not feeling that now. This is where you want to adjust the setting. So you want to take this metal piece out just by pushing it outwards like this. Sorry, I'm doing this one-handed. It's just not the best setup in the world. Very impromptu. I'm trying my best. I want to take this out. There we go. And then, once you take it out, hopefully, you can twist this top ring a little bit to the left. So I recommend you try it one or two numbers max. Don't take it all the way from 6 to 1. That's just overkill, and that might completely destroy the blades on your grinder. You don't want to jump too fine too quickly. So I'm going to jump to 4, because I've already done this before. I'm going to jump to 4 and put back the pin. So I'm going to replace this pin onto the correct spot. Hopefully you're not wasting too much of your time. There we go. I'm going to replace the burr. Like I said, all the way to the finest setting. And feel the resistance as you turn it clockwise before it clicks in place. I think it's a little bit closer now, but they're still not squeezing each other. It's still the same resistance. I'm going to do it one more time. So I'm going to jump to setting number 3 on this burr. And replace the pin. There we go. That's setting number 3. There we go. That's the one. So as I'm turning, I feel it tighten, almost like I said, like the blades are almost squeezing each other. So it gets a little bit tighter as I turn. Now, I know as a matter of fact, this setting at the moment, if I click it in place, this setting is too fine for espresso. I'm not going to keep it there. I'm going to dial it back. So after I've adjusted this fine enough to make the blades touch at the finest setting. Hopefully that makes sense. I'll reiterate. I want to reduce the number on this setting until it starts squeezing on and tightening on this top blade. I'm feeling resistance, and I'm doing this at setting number 1. Once I feel that resistance, I'm just going to lock it in place. And now I'm going to just jump back, let's say 5 numbers, and I'm going to make a coffee on it. What people tend to do, instead of feeling for the blades, they just change the setting, make a few coffees, see if that makes the pressure better, and then adjusting it again. I'm saving you time and beans by teaching you this method, so hopefully it's been valuable to you. Like I said, until they start touching at the finest setting, and then I'm going to bring it back to 6. After putting it back to 6, now I'm going to make the coffee. So at setting number 6, which is 5 larger than when they started touching, now I'm going to make a coffee, see how the pressure is. So this is going to assume, I'm going to assume that you're using fresh beans and you're using the correct dose. So for a double, it's 18 grams. If you don't have fresh beans, the pressure will be low regardless, or the beans will be really hard to get right. Make sure you use fresh beans. It'll improve your pressures and your coffees, of course. And I'm also going to assume that you're using correct amount of coffee. If you're using less than 18 grams, you'll struggle with pressure. If you're using more than 18 grams, you'll get very high pressure. So hopefully you get those two variables right. And of course, making sure you're tamping properly and distributing the coffee properly. If you're not tamping consistently, your coffee will be inconsistent. Simple as that. Hopefully this isn't too overwhelming or too difficult. And understandable by the average Joe. It's not very hard, honestly, and over time you'll be able to do this sort of as second nature. It's the same with grind size. You don't always have to make a coffee to know if the grind size is large or small, if it's the right grind size. So anyway, getting back to the point, after these adjustments, I'm gonna make a coffee now on this setting, 18 grams in, tamping properly, and then using the single wall basket. I'm going to look at the pressure and the timing. If the pressure is about 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, then I'm doing something right. Also, when you have the right pressure and the right timing, your coffee will be coming out in the right time as well. So that'll be, for a double shot, it'll be between 20 to 30 seconds. And it'll be nice and smooth when it's coming out of the spouts. If the coffee is struggling to come out of the spouts at these settings, I'm going to bring it back two numbers. Try again. If the coffee is coming out very quick at grind setting number 6, I'm going to make the coffee finer. And just a quick note on changing the grind size on these machines. You want to change the grind size only when the grinder is spinning. So I'm going to start the grinder with my hand, for example. And as it's grinding, I'm going to change it to 5. And I'm going to let it run for another 2 seconds. Why am I doing that? When you change a grind size from 6 to a 5, the beans that are coming out are still a hybrid between the old number and the new number. So now the setting, for example, I'm grinding at number 6. I find that it's too coarse because my pressure is about 10 o'clock. It's not exactly 12 o'clock. It's only 10 o'clock. I mean, pressure is not the most important thing in the world. You can still get good coffee with low pressure. But I mean, for the most part, I want to aim for about 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. Anyway, back to the point. I want to change the grind size from 6 to a 5 because I want to make my coffee run a little bit slower. I'm going to start the grind, change it, and let it run for a few seconds. Again, like I said, this is because the machine holds a little bit of coffee inside. And I want to get rid of the old setting, the number 6 setting, for a couple seconds. That's how long it'll take to purge and get rid of the old setting. After those two settings, I'm going to dump the coffee and then try again at number 5. Hopefully that makes sense. Make sure you do this with care. You don't want to damage your machine. And if you're unsure of anything, feel free to message me down in the comments. And yeah, enjoy your coffees. Cheers.